What do you do at the Alaska Sea Life Center?
I am a scientist at the Alaska Sea Life Center, and what that involves is I do several research projects here, and those projects involve the walrus project, which you just heard about. I'm also doing some video monitoring on belugas and a breeding project with stellar sea lions.
What do you enjoy most about your job?
The best thing about my job is field work and getting to work with animals. The Walrus Project, we get to go out to amazing locations, which you guys will get to see, and then also for the animals that we work with at the Sea Life Center, I get to see them every day. So being able to have that personal interaction and getting out in the field is really quite a bonus.
How did you arrive at this point in your career?
So how did I get here? I did a lot of schoolwork. So I went through my elementary education. I went to high school. I went on and got an undergraduate degree, so a four-year bachelor's degree in biology. And then I moved on to get a PhD in marine mammal physiology. And throughout my whole career, I tried to volunteer in lots of labs and lots of settings so that I could get as much experience as possible so I could determine what field I wanted to go into.
What is the biggest challenge you face at your job?
The biggest challenge that I face at in this position is having to obtain money to fund the projects. A lot of this research is really costly, especially in Alaska where we have to do a lot of traveling. And so being able to get money and secure funds that can pay my salary and the staff salary as well is a lot of paperwork, and so probably is the hardest thing I have to do.
What is the most important part of your job?
I would say the most important part of my job is being able to take the information that we get on the animals, so the walrus in particular, and be able to apply that information in a way that can help the animals. So specifically, we're looking at the impact of disturbance on walrus and if that has a population level impact. In other words, are boats, human interactions, planes flying over actually detrimental to the walrus population? So we take that data and we give it to agencies, and then agencies can find ways to protect the species.